The Eye of the World, Chapter 3, The Peddler. Haddon Fane, the peddler, draws up with his wagon on the village green outside the Wine Spring Inn. He's quickly surrounded by villagers calling for news of the outside world. The village council leave the inn, so Rand and Matt follow behind them to get a good spot, while Fane waits for an audience sufficient for his ego. The boys are joined by the blacksmith's apprentice, Perrin Ibarra, a broad-shouldered lad with curly brown hair. When Matt mentions fireworks, Perrin looks to Rand to confirm it, but Rand shouts to say later, right at the moment that the crowd falls silent, much to the lad's embarrassment. Fane begins to tell the village that their troubles with wolves and the winter are nothing compared to the outside world. There is war in Gildan, and a male channeler of the One Power has proclaimed himself as the Dragon Reborn. The crowd is alarmed and dismayed. This is the third false dragon in the last 5 years. The peddler declares that the White Tower in Tar Valon has dispatched Aes Sedai to capture the man. All through Fane's description of events, the crowd is more and more upset, with comments about the Dark One being free and the dragon being just as bad, all fueled by Sen. When Sen criticizes Ewen for asking a question, the Thatcher is called out by Bran to act his age and remember his position on the council. Seeing the upset, the mayor decides to declare this council business and take the peddler into the inn for an interview with the council. The crowd dissipates while Matt tells his friends that a merchant guard once told him that the dragon would be reborn during mankind's greatest hour of need. Rand and Perrin scoff at this and discuss if Aes Sedai are really dark friends, as they did cause the breaking of the world. Matt tells the tale of Billy Conger naming the Dark One and causing his crops to be blighted and his family sicken. He won't do it now, even if Matt dares him to. "You're just stupid enough to do that, Matrin Cawthon," says the Wisdom, having just appeared behind them. Tugging at her long dark braid, she rebukes the boys for talking of such things. They try to explain that the talk was natural after hearing what the peddler said, which Nynaeve reveals that she hadn't heard. She was tending the sick Mistress Aiellyn. Rand then notices that Egwene is with her, trying not to smile as the boys are squirming. Nynaeve proclaims that the boys are unfit to be off apron strings and needs to make sure that the council are asking the right questions. Without thinking, Rand asks Egwene to dance with him at Beltane, only after noticing that her hair is now braided, signifying her of marriageable age. Egwene tells him she will later in the day, as in the morning she'll be doing her first dance of the spring pole. Rand declares that people don't have to wed as soon as they come of age, and Egwene takes offence. She tells him Wisdom's rarely wed, and she's to become Nynaeve's apprentice. As Nynaeve is so young, she'll most likely move to another village. Rand is incredulous, claiming people don't leave Emmonsfield. It's a fantasy and a daydream. Meanwhile, Matt has been talking to Perrin about the Dark Rider, and tells Rand that Perrin has seen him too, as well as getting the same coin from Moraine. Perrin tells him that when he saw the rider, he pointed him out to Master Luhan, but then he disappeared. But ever since, the blacksmith's been carrying around his biggest hammer just in case. Egwene overhears all of this and interrupts, asking what they're talking about. After she's told, she claims Nynaeve is right about them being children. How stupid of them to spread rumours like this during such a trying time. The tirade stops as an angry man comes storming out of the inn.